Good afternoon. This is Brian Ehrman coming to you from North Vancouver, British Columbia at Canlan Ice Sports Center, where the Everett Junior Silver Tips 16U team is going to face off with the North Vancouver Storm. I'm here, as always, with the voice of the Junior Silver Tips, Mike Mietzma.
Hey, good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to North Vancouver.
How's it feel to be back in the motherland?
You know, it feels great. I came across the border, and I immediately felt happy and refreshed.
Very nice, very nice. Back in your element.
Back in my element, yep. So it's nice. It's nice to be back out on the ice here after the Christmas break. We'll see. We'll see how many of these. Players have been sitting on their butts for a week, and who is not?
Yeah, I don't know how many boys were making it out for stick and puck and private lessons. Certainly, a few were. We were off in Colorado, and Orion went out a couple times, played on the pond. Did a little pond hockey, and made it out and played in Littleton, Colorado as well at Ice Center there. So,
oh, really?
Got a little workout.
Oh, nice. Yeah, I saw a couple Facebook posts where Ryan was all by himself there on the outdoor ice sheet. It's nice to see.
Always fun to play outdoors. Got to take that opportunity when you can.
Oh, certainly, certainly. So today we're playing the Vancouver Storm. This is an A3 team.
Storm and their blue look a little bit like the Toronto Maple Leafs down there at the other end.
Yeah, certainly do. Those are nice, very nice uniforms. So we're trying out some new gear today. Christmas was very, very good to me this year, and so our recordings are going to have zero hockey noise. Actually, you're not going to hear any of the game today.
Considering we're up here behind the glass, I don't know you would have heard anything but background noise anyway.
Well, that's true, right?
We'll have to put an ambiance mic on here when we're down in the
stadium.
Yeah,
exactly. Yeah, this little box here has a auxiliary for a microphone, or there's a hot shoe mic here. So
perfect.
We can see how that.
Well, it looked like Santa Claus was very good to you this season.
It certainly was. So was Craigslist. Craigslist was Santa Claus this year.
It's perfect.
So we'll see how this goes up against this white mesh. See how it works against the focusing and whatnot. And so we're about ready to start the hockey game. Do we have any scratches, Brian, that you know of?
I believe Nuke is not with us today. Still in California on vacation.
And I believe Jake Frost is not with us as well.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah. So they're lining up for the faceoff. We have Herman, Mietzma, and Meineker tied up in the corner. Comes back to McCutcheon. McCutcheon whiffs on it. It comes back to Strindkirk. Strindkirk in goal. Comes up for Meineker on the high slot. Gets disrupted. McCutcheon falls on the play, and it goes back into the Vancouver zone. Chased down by Mietzma. Picked up by Herman. Herman takes a shot. Comes back for Walton at the blue line. It's going to get called. What do you think that call was?
I'm not entirely sure. Face off in the zone.
There's some good aggressive play here by Everett so far.
I can't for the life of me figure out what they stopped the play for.
Yeah, I'm not sure. I saw a player laying on the ice, but it was unclear who it was.
Yeah, 2 minutes up on the clock, though.
So we got Althoff in the corner battling hard. Comes back to the blue line, caught up by Gaumont. Gaumont slides it over to Anderson. Anderson tries to take a shot. It gets blocked. Comes back behind the Vancouver zone. Vancouver trying to get it out. Comes on the side boards, and Vancouver pops it all the way over the Everett zone, and it goes behind the net for Strindkirk.
So there was a penalty called on Vancouver, but I did not see what the call was. It's a minute 30 to go in the power play for Everett.
Comes up for Holland. It looks like he got called on the offside. a little odd here recording and commentating from behind the glass. You don't get to hear any of the sounds, any of the whistles.
Yeah, it's strangely quiet.
Comes back for Corson. Corson feeds it to the net. Comes for Lombard at the sideboards. Or that's Rohde, excuse me. Rohde pops it behind the Vancouver net. Comes off for Vancouver. Vancouver streaming into the Everett net. He comes up, makes a pass, wheels and deals on the corner.
Good stop by Strankert.
Yep.
Net dislodged.
Almost pops it in the corner. Good job by Strankert to really read that play.
Play started. McCutcheon's lost his feet there on the far side boards. And left us with just one defenseman back.
So we have Herman, Mietzma, Walton, and Meineker out. McCutcheon tries to feed it up, but falls on the play. Comes out for Herman. Herman slides it up to Mietzma. Mietzma streams over the line, goes wide. Looks to take a shot out front for Meineker, but Meineker can't quite connect to it. Comes out to the blue line. Vancouver streaming gets picked off by McCutcheon and grabbed up by Walton. Walton streaming behind the Everett net, comes out of the blue line for Vancouver. Vancouver picks it up and pops it back for Strankert. Strankert behind the net. Comes for McCutcheon, but McCutcheon waves it off. Picked up by Herman.
7 seconds left in the power play.
Herman trying to make a pass to Mietzma, doesn't connect, and it goes for icing. It'll come all the way back to the Everett zone. That was a good time for Everett to change. So we've got Lombard, Althoff, and Anderson with Gaumont and Paulin. Grabbed up by Gaumont behind the Everett net. Spins, looking for space up to Anderson. Comes back behind the net. Comes out for Lombard. Lombard up to Anderson. Anderson streaming through the zone.
Oh, shot in.
That was a beautiful shot. Beautiful shot by Lombard. That was that Althoff? Althoff feeding that, or was that Anderson?
I'm not positive. I was thinking it was Althoff, but I'm not positive about
that.
No,
it was Anderson streaming over to the left-hand side and brought it over to Lombard. So score is now 1-0 for Everett. Althoff wins that faceoff. It comes back to Gaumont at the blue line. Gaumont feeds it up. It gets blocked by Vancouver. Hop back up, and Vancouver has it in the corner. Vancouver spins, they take a weak shot blocked by Gaumont. Gaumont slides it for Althoff in the corner. Althoff gets pasted on the boards, picked up by Vancouver. Vancouver shuffles it behind the Everett net, picked up by
another penalty. Oh,
and that's going to be another penalty. Penalty, I believe. Yeah, number
tripping.
20.
Yep.
Vancouver coming out playing very aggressive today.
Team manager mentioned that this Vancouver team has had a number of penalties this year. Aggressive play.
Yeah, they're a very aggressive team. We got Wyrick on the faceoff. Lost the faceoff. It was chased down by Rohde. Comes back into the zone by Rohde. Rohde spins, takes a quick stop, feeds it up to Walton. Walton streams up, tries to connect with Wyrick. Comes back. Rohde has it on the right-hand side. He gets tripped up, and it comes out for McCutcheon on the blue line. McCutcheon shuffles it back in. It comes back out to the blue line. McCutcheon takes a shot, whiffs on it. I think McCutcheon is having a hard time hanging on to the puck today. Wonder if he grew a couple inches over Christmas.
Could be. Could also be that he made another trip to Canadian Tire on on our last Canadian soiree. McCutchen had to get his skates sharpened, and he got it done at Canadian Tire. So who knew?
Who knew that Canadian Tire, the all-service tire place, also sharpens skates.
That's right. Whatever method you're moving with, Canadian Tire is keeping you going.
That's right. Comes back behind the Everett net for McCutchen. McCutchen spins, looks for Mietsma. Mietsma looks for Herman. Herman hat is back turned. Comes up on the sideboards for Orion. Big battle. Comes up to the blue line for Gaumont. Gaumont over to Poland. Poland up to Mietsma. Mietsma spins and shuffles it towards the net. And it gets whiffed off by the goalie. Vancouver does a long flop pass into the corner of Everett's zone. Looks like the puck's tied up. It's digged out. They're digged out.
Dig dug.
Yeah, dig dug. Dug out.
Ooh.
Comes up on the sideboards for Mietsma. Gets disrupted.
Gaumont got squished on the boards there.
Mietsma up to, or not Mietsma, Gaumont up to Herman. Herman can't quite hang on to it. Goes behind the Vancouver net up to the sideboards. Chased down by Meineker, disrupted by Walton. Comes up for Walton at the blue line. He looks to do something with it, but loses it at the blue line. Should have passed over to Meineker there. Shot from Vancouver gets blocked by Altoff. Picked up by Lombard on the sideboard. Lombard tried to connect to Anderson. Anderson chasing it down the ice behind the Vancouver net. Comes out of the sideboards, disrupted by McCutchen. McCutchen throws it back behind the net. Comes right out front for Altoff.
Nice.
Oh, Altoff got his first goal of
Beautiful.
The season.
Beautiful
Great
feed
job.
From Anderson.
Great job by Altoff. Beautiful feed from Anderson. This is a great day here for Altoff because it's his first goal of the season. He's had many, many, many chances, and we've made comments that hasn't been able to buy a goal. So
yeah.
Today was the day. Great
start,
day
start
in the Altoff
the
family.
Right. First goal of the year.
Yep. I guess Altoff can now get a ride home. So the score is 2-0 in favor of Everett. Comes out of the sideboard for Wyrick. Wyrick gets pasted on the boards. It comes out for Vancouver. Everett playing very aggressive. Lost the puck in the heat there. Gets picked up by Vancouver. Vancouver wheels and deals, but gets taken out by Gaumont. Gaumont doing a great job today. Comes up on the sideboard for Rohde. Rohde tries to pick it off. Comes back for Poland.
Nifty move there by number 20 for Vancouver. Didn't work out for him, but
yep.
It was a cool move.
Very, very aggressive on the sideboard for Vancouver. Poland tips it up for Rohde. Rohde does a backhand up the ice, chased down by Corson. Corson
nice called.
Nice job there by Corson to chase down that that puck.
He hustled in enough that I thought they might wave the icing off, but
yep.
They did not.
They did not.
Well, hey, even though the new Kays aren't here, I want to give a shout out to Mike and Melissa for hosting a fantastic holiday party for us right after our last games before the break.
Yeah, that was a great get together. It's nice to. You know, nice to do a meet and greet with all the families, and, you know, it was a great night.
Yeah, it was a good time.
Looks like Everett may have a penalty here. Nice shot here by Vancouver. Strinker giving up a pretty strong rebound. Mietzma on the sideboards. comes out for Vancouver. Vancouver streaming into the zone. Haken a shot blocked by Stringkirk right on the sideboards. Huffled away by Stringkirk, comes back to the blue line. Rifle shot gets blocked by Herman.
Great block.
It was like flying like Superman. Comes back behind and McCutcheon skates out of the body check. Doesn't like to be hit. Shot that gets blocked and it comes right out front, goes into the corner for Mietzma. Mietzma battling hard in the corner. Comes out for McCutcheon. McCutcheon slides it out, but it gets blocked there at center ice and it comes right back in the zone. McCutcheon backhands it back to the blue line. It goes back out to center ice for Vancouver. Everett will do a half a line change here. Comes up for McCutcheon. Everett doing a pretty good job killing this penalty. Comes back to the blue line. Meineker stuffs it out of the zone and Everett will go for a line change. Althoff out with Anderson.
Yeah, Herman finally got off after a minute 40.
Yeah,
that was a long shift.
That was a long shift. Behind Everett net. Vancouver gets pasted by Gaumont. Picked up by Vancouver. Vancouver spinning. And they're trying to jam it into the net. Good job by Stringkirk to keep that out of the net.
That ended the penalty kill. Fantastic kill by Everett. One of the better ones I've seen this season.
Yep. So we'll have a face-off in the Everett zone. And Everett's back at full strength. Comes back to the blue line. It gets poked out, chased down by Anderson. Anderson can't quite get to it. A breakout by Vancouver, good play by Vancouver. Vancouver behind the Everett net. Pushes it back behind, gets grabbed by Althoff. Althoff can't hang on to it. Vancouver keeps possession of it. Vancouver does a backhand.
Nice play by Strinkert there.
Yep. Good aggressive play there by Poland. Lombard over to Anderson. Anderson tried to get to it but got off the ice. Shot to Stringkirk. Stringkirk shuffles it off to Gaumont. Gaumont, well, it goes up to Rohde and it goes into the Vancouver zone. And it looks like for the icing, that's going to be a
penalty called on that.
Yep.
Rohde looks, he collapses there. And, he's getting to his feet, holding his back.
Not very happy about that, I suppose.
Oh, he slashed a guy as he went by. Or at least it looked like he did. Maybe he gave him a Y-I-Ota. Rohde's sometimes good at dodging hits. At the Christmas party, Mietzma, I believe it was, hucked a couch pillow at him, and Rohde dodged out of the way, and the pillow went out through an open window and out into the outside.
Oh, it did?
Yeah. It was quite awesome, actually. I may have falsely accused Mietzma, but he was in the area when that pillow was thrown.
He was in the area. Comes right out front for Mietzma. Mietzma can't connect to it. Comes back for Walton. Walton spins at the blue line up to Mietzma. Mietzma's not quite ready for that shenanigans from Walton. Over to McCutcheon. McCutcheon disrupts the Vancouver player enough for Walton to collect the puck and do a spin here in the Everett zone. Walton wheels and deals to the whole ice there, but gets knocked off the play at the blue line.
40 seconds of the power play have gone by. Everett's yet to set anything up. Oh, McCutcheon loses it.
Good job there by Stringkirk to stop that little scrum behind the Everett net.
Is that McCutcheon mixing it up a little bit there? And Meineker kind of calming everybody back down. So minute 4 left in the power play. Everett still selecting their line.
There we go. We'll go ahead and have a face-off here just outside the Everett zone.
Herman's in with Meineker. Who's the other forward on this line? Oh. Looks like a penalty penalty was called here. Maybe I didn't see the hand signal, but I'm guessing it was for some of the after the shot shenanigans there. So it looks like it's going to be 4-on-4 for the next minute and four, and then there'll be a one-minute advantage for Vancouver. That explains why I couldn't find the third forward.
There you go. Comes back for Herman on the sideboards. Vancouver dumps it in. Gets collected by Poland. Poland over to Meineker on the sideboards. Comes back to the blue line for Vancouver. Vancouver shuffles it back into the zone.
Aggressive forechecking by Vancouver here on this 4-on-4.
Yeah.
They're all over the Everett forwards.
Yep. Comes right out front.
Herman got manhandled there, pushed off the puck.
Rifle shot gets blocked, gets picked up by Vancouver. Vancouver doing just a wheeling and dealing.
Yeah.
Yeah. You know what? Everett relaxed just a little bit, and, they let Vancouver walk right in.
Yeah, agreed. Everett just couldn't find their feet, I think, on that 4-on-4 opportunity. Not only were they not able to break anything out and get any play started, but they were really back on their heels.
Yep. Looks like we're doing an alternating forward here.
The bummer of that is it was an even strength goal, and so the penalty remains.
Yep.
Still a minute 10 to go in the Everett penalty. About 20 seconds left in the penalty for Vancouver.
So Everett came out strong here in the beginning of the first period. Now it looks like they're throttling off a little bit.
Great bit of work there.
Really, really aggressive here by Everett. Comes up to the blue line and a bit of aggressiveness here by Anderson. Comes back to the corner for Poland. Poland slides it over to Walton. Walton does a cross-ice pass, chased down by Lombard. Lombard takes a shot. It comes for Anderson right out front.
Good shorthanded opportunity there for Everett. 20 seconds to go.
Yeah,
now
good,
15 in the penalty.
Good sliding save here by the Vancouver Storm goalie. Vancouver comes streaming over the blue line. And they take a shot that gets blocked by Stringkirk. Vancouver back out to the top of the circle. Rifle shot, blocker save goes over the net. Grabbed up by Gaumont. Gaumont up to Rohde. Rohde can't quite hang on to it, and it will come out to the blue line. Disrupted by Rohde. Rohde takes a nice shot, goes into the corner, and they bank it off the boards, comes back to the Everett defense.
Everett back at even strength with a minute 13 to go in the period.
Comes to the sideboards for Rohde. Rohde spins but can't hold on to it. It gets picked up by Vancouver. Vancouver with a good use of the boards here. Comes right out front of the blue line. Whiff shot here by Gaumont. Comes out for Wyrick right in the front, picked up by Rohde. Really aggressive play here by both Everett and Vancouver.
Hooking penalty called. I gotta say, this Vancouver team plays a really physical and aggressive game, but nothing dirty about it at all.
No,
the hits are all clean. They're all fair.
Yeah, they're just playing incredibly physical.
Yeah, and they go hard at the puck. They take a lot of gambles. There have been a couple of cool dives, and they play aggressively after that puck. I like it.
Oh, yeah, yep. Certainly. Comes back to the blue line here. Gaumont can't get his stick on it, and it will come all the way back. The Everett grabbed up by Poland.
First real mistake I've seen from Gaumont this period. He's had a nice period defensively.
Goes up to Mietzma. Mietzma gets pasted on the boards. That looked a little rough there. He was
off. Right back up.
Yep, that's good. Comes up for Vancouver. Vancouver over the Everett blue line. Wheeling and dealing, getting disrupted. grabbed up by Herman, shuffles it over to Meineker. Meineker over the blue line to Mietzma. Mietzma can't quite connect to it. Comes right out front for Meineker. Meineker takes a shot, gets blocked, and it gets rifled all the way to the Everett zone.
Nice shot by Meineker. That was a fun last few seconds, really turning on the Jets as the period went to a close.
That was great. So we'll have a couple minute break here. We'll go ahead and leave the camera on, and we'll have some words of wisdom here by Brian Herman.
Man, you may want to turn the camera off. I didn't hear any words of wisdom. I like what I saw here today. That was maybe one of the more aggressive periods we've played. We've certainly had some more physical periods against other teams, but they've been, I'd say, you know, more foolish hits and retaliatory kind of play. This has been just good aggressive puck play.
No, I completely agree. I think both these teams are playing, you know, nice and aggressive, a little bit physical, but nothing overly dirty after the play, like you were saying.
Yeah, absolutely. And I think our defense looks nice today. It's, like I said, I saw good things from Gaumont there, and I think was it Poland that was playing? No, Walton. I'm sorry, Walton was playing back and having a nice game defensively as well.
Yep. I think, you know, as we've said before, I think Everett needs to play more of a stay-at-home D. I think we saw a couple times where we have, you know, a defenseman pinching forward, and then, you know, we have a turnover there at center ice, and they end up having a 2-on-1 or a 1-on-1. It's a situation that Everett needs to avoid that.
Most of the time that I've seen that today, I think it's been true. It's been the defenseman pinching up, but losing his skates, and then you know, there's no recovering from that.
Mm-mm. No, I agree.
But a good period of hockey, not just with a couple of goals, but I think all around decent play. Strankert looking really strong in net today too.
Yep. I agree. So we'll go. We'll start this second period with Everett up 2-1. I believe Vancouver's in the box, right?
That's right. Still a minute 15. Wait. That's right. I'm sorry. Vancouver's in the box. Still a minute 15 to go in that penalty. That was the tripping call near the end of the first period.
That's right. So we'll see if Everett can make something happen here. So we have the Everett line, Herman, Mietzma, and Meineker picked up by Walton. Walton taking a wee little shot. Comes to the corner, chased down by Walton. Again, this is exactly what we were talking about. Walton playing defense, and you find him all the way down here in the Vancouver corner with pretty significant blank spot back on back on defense.
Yeah, that puck not gone up into the bench. Yep. That could have been an opportunity the other way.
So Vancouver streaming into Everett, just dumps it, gets tipped by Poland, right to center ice, collected back by Poland and pushed back to the Vancouver blue line, or actually the Everett blue line, excuse me. Comes up for Herman. Herman does a backhand over to Mietzma. Can't quite connect to it. It's grabbed up by Walton. Back to Poland. Poland doing a nice turn, looking for an Everett player. Comes back again. Walton is playing way high. Comes up for Mietzma. Mietzma takes a shot, rifles it over the net. Goes back to the Vancouver blue line. It comes out. Again, one defenseman. I don't like seeing that. Vancouver slides it up, slides it back to their defenseman, trying to set something up. A great job here by Vancouver. They slide right into the zone. It gets disrupted. Comes up for Lombard. I'm not sure what. I'm not sure what the heck that was. What.
Well, he was unhappy with whatever the call was, and I can't tell. Looks like it may be a penalty on Lombard.
So he just takes the puck and throws it?
Yeah, apparently.
That's,
when you're dissatisfied with the call, you throw the puck over.
not exactly sure what.
I'm wondering if he's going to get a second penalty for an unsportsmanlike on that.
Yeah, I don't know.
So, 2-minute call on Lombard.
For
shenanigans unknown.
Shenanigans unknown. We're going to have to ask him about that because that was.
Review the score sheet after the game on that one.
Comes back to the blue line for Vancouver. Vancouver takes it all the way back to their blue line. Spins and turns and drags it in. Drags it into the corner. All the way back to the blue line. Gets disrupted by Poland. Poland tries to slide it out. It comes out of the zone. Grabbed up by Altoff. Altoff
nice
over to McCutchen. McCutchen takes a shot and goes wide of the net.
Strange place to find our defenseman on a penalty kill, but it was a good opportunity.
I have a feeling McCutchen is playing high. Yeah. He's playing forward. So McCutchen comes up and tries to chase it down behind the Vancouver net.
Yeah, a little pirouette there in the corner.
Comes back, disrupted by Herman. I think Herman, or Altoff, sorry, was trying to get off the ice. That was a bad line change there, I think. Walton spins on the sideboard, comes up for Wyrick. Wyrick slides it into the zone.
Good clear.
Yep, that was a good clear. Comes over the red line, clears it. Vancouver cross ice pass.
It's easy for you to say.
Yeah, geez. Comes back to the blue line, cross ice to the other Vancouver defenseman, slides it behind the Everett net. Walton gains control of it behind the net. It comes out center ice for Rohde. Rohde does a backhand, dumps it. Chased down by Wyrick.
3 seconds, and the penalty's over. Back to even strength.
Comes back to the red line. Cross ice pass for Vancouver. And chased down by Walton.
Nice speed by the Vancouver player there getting to that puck.
Yep. Comes back out of the zone for Vancouver. Vancouver does a great job doing these little backhand plays. Behind the net for Walton. Walton spins to Everett. Everett tries to pop it up. It gets disrupted by Vancouver. Vancouver gains control of it. And they have it over on the right-hand side of the ice. They pop it into the Everett corner for Walton. Comes out, shot by Vancouver. And it goes wide, comes to the left-hand side of the ice. Vancouver pops it down into the Everett zone, comes right back out to the blue line. It gets... comes right... open, wide open shot there for Vancouver.
Penalty called.
Yep.
The big hit after the play there with Everett player taking the Vancouver player out.
Yep, that's the after the play shenanigans that we talk about.
Yeah, you got to stay out of that. I mean, Strinker, the shot was clear and easy for him to field, to get right in the chest.
Yep.
Simple plays over. No need to add anything to that.
So who's going to the box?
Well, actually, it appears it might be a Vancouver player.
Oh.
I assume that was on us for a late hit.
Yeah, I thought so, too.
But Vancouver's got 4 players out on the ice there.
So we will have a power play for seemingly 2 minutes.
Meets my one of our assistant coaches, assistant captains over there on the side, checking things out. Now there's nothing on the board, and there's.
I wonder if it's an incidental then.
Yeah, maybe.
The big shot on the net there by Vancouver. It misses the net and chased down by Herman. Herman long pass to Meineker. Meineker can't quite connect to it. Moniker does a good job trying to chase that down. And it will come all the way back to the Everett zone for a faceoff.
Yeah, Flo couldn't quite get back to that one. Incidentally, Flo has a New Year's resolution. He is going to make sure that he brushes his hair 20 times a day, and he's going to use all-natural tea tree oil conditioner on that hair.
Ah, beautiful. Come back to the blue line here for Lombard. Lombard tries to feed it out, but Vancouver comes streaming into the zone, and they stuff it past Stringkirk.
Quick goal makes it 2-2. 9:33 in the second period. Hasn't been a lot of offense out of Everett in the second period. Not up to what they were doing in the first.
No.
All right, well, it's time to get it going here. We've got ourselves a brand new game.
Doesn't look like Everett's really, connecting with their passing. They're doing a lot of emergency moves, just trying to collect it. It goes back to McCutchen. It looks like McCutchen is back on defense. McCutchen has it behind the Everett net, looking for something to do. Streams out, puts it right out front, gets collected by Vancouver. It's not the right play there. Vancouver has it. They bring it back to the blue line. Back on the sideboard. Comes right out front for Everett. Everett streaming through the zone. Well, that's Walton. Looking, Walton loses it, just pops it behind the net for nobody. Comes back to the blue line for Althoff.
Waited just a little long to pull the trigger on that. Yep. The defenseman got in position.
Walton with a shot that goes wide, goes on the right-hand side. Comes back for Wyrick on the blue line. Chased down by Vancouver. Vancouver over the Everett blue line. Takes a shot. Really nice disruption by McCutchen.
Penalty call.
We got some words
tripping
here. Who's that penalty going to be on?
I'm assuming I didn't see it, but the way McCutchen went down, I think he may have been the one that got tripped.
That's Vancouver.
Yeah,
there,
tripping on Vancouver.
All right. So Everett's on the power play.
All right, good opportunity to get the offense going again here. Have you seen Corson out on the ice today? I haven't spotted his number.
He's actually number 16
there.
Yep. Comes up for Vancouver on the blue line, and they just throw it back into the Everett zone. Chased down here by Gaumont. Gaumont up to Corson. Corson back to Gaumont. Gaumont streams up looking for Everett, but Everett's got their back turned.
30 seconds gone already.
Good disruption by Herman. Everett has it on the sideboards, makes a turn. It's pinched on the boards there by Everett, goes up to the boards for Corson. Over to Wyrick. Wyrick on the sideboards, spins and
nice
turns,
move.
Looking. Goes over for Corson. Corson misses the net. Picked up by Wyrick. Wyrick gets double teamed there.
Big collision.
Yeah, it's on the sideboards here for Anderson. Anderson looking. Nice rebound up front. Herman shuffles it right in front of the net. Looking. Goes on the sideboard for Poland. Poland takes a shot. Gets blocked by Everett.
Nice work by Herman to get back on top of that puck before it got free.
Comes back to the blue line. It gets tipped by Vancouver. It's a good thing they were looking for a line change, because that would have been...
I was a little surprised that Vancouver didn't chase after that, but that was
Walton,
a long shift for them.
All by himself, tries to wheel and deal through three defensemen.
Oh, that was a rough hit.
That's
called.
Have to, We're going to have to review that.
Head contact.
Yeah. It was head contact on Althoff, right?
Walton.
Or Walton.
Yeah, Walton's head into the box. Ah, it was a rough hit.
Ah. Walton's known for that aggressive play. He likes those type of hits.
Well, that'll negate the remaining 12 mm-hmm. seconds of the power play for Everett.
Mietzma taking the face off with McCutcheon and Meineker and Gaumont. Nice face-off when they're picked up by McCutcheon, slides it over to Meineker to Mietzma. Mietzma streams through it, takes a shot, gets blocked by the goalie, picked up by Vancouver.
Everett's now on the penalty kill.
There's a good chance there by Mietzma, but Mietzma put it right into the pads, looking for the five hole of the goalie.
Scary moment there. With Gaumont didn't know that the Vancouver player had snuck in behind him there.
Oh yeah. So we'll come back for a face-off here in the Vancouver zone. Comes into the corner, chased down by Mietzma. Vancouver long cross ice pass over the blue line, taking a look, picked up by Vancouver. Cross ice pass. Takes a shot, gets blocked, goes wide. Comes back to the sideboard for Vancouver. Chased down by Mietzma. Mietzma digging hard in the corner. Shot goes wide by Vancouver, comes back to the blue line.
Minute left in the penalty kill.
Disrupted at the blue line, picked up by McCutcheon. McCutcheon takes a weak shot and it goes wide of the net. Vancouver streams up over the Everett blue line, drops it back again. Comes out top of the circle for a shot, gets blocked by Strinkirk. And it's in the Everett corner. Everett doing a good job on this penalty kill. Comes back for Althoff. Althoff taking a shot, goes wide. Picks up his own rebound. Waiting for an Everett player. Comes back for Poland. Poland slides it to the blue line, but there's nobody there. Good job by Gaumont to try to mitigate that.
Teams are at even strength.
Althoff stops circle, drops it back for Walton. Walton's out of the box?
Yep.
Okay.
Yep, just at even strength.
So it wasn't a 10-2?
Nope.
Okay. Comes back to the blue line, draw back for Vancouver. Vancouver gets pinched on the boards there by Everett. Comes back to the blue line for Vancouver.
And this rink is one of the ones where they have the penalty boxes right next to the benches, so it's really
hard
to tell who's
really
in
tough.
And who's not and whether there's a major penalty and an extra player sitting.
That is not the time for a line change, boys. Vancouver up on the right-hand sideboards, drops it back, gets collected by Gaumont. Gaumont gets hit on the boards, grabbed up by Vancouver. Vancouver tries to shuffle it up, gets disrupted by Herman. Herman over to Walton. Not sure where that went. Oh, it comes back into Vancouver zone. Vancouver seems to always have a guy right at that blue line. Gaumont pops it out of the Everett zone, and it comes back for Vancouver.
2.5 minutes left in the second period. Line change for Everett.
Vancouver spins and brings it up to the blue line, collected by McCutcheon. McCutcheon over to Walton. And Vancouver pops it into the Everett zone. Nice and quiet up here.
It is. It's a little weird.
It's like it's a little weird. Oh. That was a long shot there. It's probably a screenshot from Vancouver. Goes over the shoulder of Strinkirk.
Yeah, beat him stick side high. Minute 54 left in the second period. 3-2, Vancouver leads.
Well, so far, this is a pretty tight game.
I feel like Everett definitely had the upper hand in the first period, but it's been almost all Vancouver here in the second.
Yeah, yeah. I agree. Comes back for Walton at the blue line. Walton tries to tip it off the boards, but doesn't know there's no glass on the boards there, so it goes into the player bench. So we'll have a face-off here in the Everett zone.
Swapping out the Vancouver player.
Comes out of the zone. Vancouver pops it back into the Everett zone, chased down by McCutcheon, comes up to the blue line. Vancouver has it on the left-hand side. Vancouver streams behind the Everett net. And it looks like maybe the net's off.
I think so. Well, we'll reset, bring out some fresh lines.
Yep.
You know, back to the holiday party, there's a monster game of hide-and-seek for the boys after all the gift-giving was done. And apparently Gumont and Thomas Polin went off and hid somewhere together, and the boys never did find them. The two finally wandered back together, and the boys had given up looking already.
Really?
Yeah. So hide-and-seek champions.
That's funny.
Polin and Gumont. Polin, along with Anderson, both had nice goals in our last game against Burnaby.
Yeah, that's true, yeah.
That was, I think, further reinforcing the Planderson player.
The Planderson player. Wasn't that the first game? Because the second game was the Mietzma hat trick, right?
Yeah, it was the all-Mietzma show. That's
right. The Planderson was the
Saturday game.
Was that Saturday game, I thought, yeah. Chased down by Corson. Can't hang on to it, and it goes back for Polin. Polin wheels and dumps it on the boards. They're looking for Corson.
Just under 30 seconds left in the period.
I think Everett's going to have to get their stuff together. There's a 2-on-1 here. Quickly chased
nice
on there by Vancouver. Nice pass over to Althoff.
Well
comes
defended.
Back to the blue line, yeah. Comes back behind the Vancouver net. They'll wheel and look for something there at the blue line.
Yeah, I think they were content to just run out the period there behind
the
net.
Oh, I think so, yeah.
Make sure that we didn't get another opportunity.
Yep. Oh, I agree with that. All right, so give us a rundown of that period.
Well, in that period, I felt like lost a little bit of the offensive success we were seeing in the first period from Everett. The passing wasn't as crisp, and even though we were hustling around, we seemed to be much more reactive rather than making smart plays. So Vancouver, on the other hand, seemed like they found their offensive wheels, kind of got themselves organized, played as good a game as they were being aggressive, but with better offense in the second period.
Yeah, I think I think Vancouver's got a great breakout. They're they're always they always have a guy standing in the upper neutral zone, not necessarily standing at the blue line, but there's always a guy roving in that in that upper neutral zone for that cross ice pass. And I think Everett's defensive minded defense then hit in a little bit of trouble there.
I'd love to see the shots on goal. I haven't been tracking them myself, and always lazily enjoy it when the scorekeeper does it for us up on the boards.
Yeah.
But I suspect that that Everett had the advantage in the first period and was probably significantly behind in the second period. Felt like Strinkert faced quite a number of shots that period.
Yeah, I think that I think that Everett, like you were saying, Everett was playing pretty aggressive in the first period, and I think if they want to take away this win, they're going to have to find some of that energy that they had in the first period.
Yeah, absolutely. A little bit better passing, a little bit quicker to the puck.
So we'll go ahead and start off this third period. The score 3-2 in favor of the Vancouver Storm.
So for those of you who've managed to catch the audio on some of our previous broadcasts, you'll know that one of our standard segments is Elmer Fudd's What Won't Weirich Remember? covering Aiden Weirich and his perpetual forgetting of hockey equipment. Now, I unfortunately didn't have an opportunity to run anything down before the game with his mother, but I do know that he has two sticks because he had his stick broken at the late in the second period there. He's out here on the ice as center with a new stick. So,
well, either he borrowed one.
Oh, that could be too.
Or he had an extra one. I was fully prepared and brought the extra jerseys in the car
just in case.
Fully expecting one of these players to do exactly that.
Well, and actually Weirich's previous stick looked like one of the black sticks, and I see the one he's got now is white. So, I don't know, maybe he did borrow. I'll run that down this evening and we'll know tomorrow.
What Weirich wouldn't remember? That's great. Thank you, Brian Herman, for the segment of What Weirich Wouldn't Remember. Vancouver behind the Everett net. It's dropped back. It's like they're on a power play, but they're playing very, very aggressively behind our net. They drop it back behind our net, not being chased down at all by our defense. Comes off for Weirich. Weirich up to Corson. Corson can't hold on to it. Shot gets blocked by Strinker. Goes to the right-hand corner. Collected again by Vancouver. Everett not being very aggressive. This is not what we want to see if we want to win a hockey game.
No, moving slowly here and just sort of chasing the play around.
Yep.
Oh, boy. Early on the whistle there from the official, I assume he lost sight of the puck, but luckily Everett was on top of that anyway.
I'm sure that's what happened, yep. They're like, it was in, it was out, lost visibility of the puck. Good job by Strinkirk. Not a lot of help by the Everett defenseman there.
You know, I mentioned at the top of the game that Herman got a little pond hockey in while we were back in Colorado at Christmas. The day we played was like the second day that was below freezing for the entire day.
Yeah,
so
when
he was heading out, you know, his mother and I were suggesting that that might be a bad idea. But as teenagers will do, he rolled his eyes and continued.
Yeah, yeah.
And as the boys were leaving the ice, one of the guys who was there with him fell through up to his waist, had to crawl out. No one got hurt, and all the boys had a good laugh, but
nice.
They didn't go back on the pond after that.
They didn't go back out on the pond, no. Lombard cross-ice pass for Mietzma. Mietzma streaming through the zone, tries to wheel and deal, puts it towards the net, gets tripped up on the play.
He wheeled, but he had no deal.
Yeah, there was no happy ending there. Maybe happy ending was not the right word to use.
It's possible.
Walton
shoots and scores.
Walton takes a rifle shot there and goes over the shoulder of the Vancouver goalie.
Well, that was kind of unexpected.
Not sure who, was that Walton or was that Meineker? I couldn't tell.
To be honest, I don't know.
Well,
I was checking my notes when
we'll have to wait for
that began. I just saw it go in.
The review.
So our apologies there to whoever that was. We'll check it on the scoreboard after the score sheet after the game.
Yeah, we'll make mention of it tomorrow.
Nice goal. Gets us tied up 3-3. 15:50 left in the third period.
Pulling up to Anderson. That was Planderson right there.
Indeed it was.
Comes up for Corson. Corson gets taken off of his feet. He had his head down at the boards there. And
penalty's been called here.
It's a little bit of a
dangerous
situation.
That was delayed offsides.
That was delayed.
Sorry about that.
It's okay. Comes up for Althoff. Althoff gets pasted on the boards. Comes back for Corson. Corson dumps it into the Vancouver zone and chases it down. Cross-ice pass for Vancouver. Vancouver brings it up. Comes right out, gets disrupted by Corson. Corson again gets taken off of his feet, comes back for Poland behind the Everett net. I think Everett has to, sliding it up the boards looking for that breakout because there's nobody there. Vancouver does a spin and they take a shot.
Beautiful kick save by Strinkert.
Yeah, that was beautiful. Great job. Grabbed up here by Gaumont. Gaumont looking to get something done. Puts it towards center ice, but gets collected by Vancouver, and they dump it right back behind the Everett net. Out for Gaumont. Gaumont throws it away. Here we got three Everett players on the sideboards here. Mietzma up to Herman. Herman pops it up for Rohde. Rohde tries to do something on the sideboards, but can't quite hang on to it. And it comes up to center ice for Vancouver. Vancouver streams into the zone.
Oh, no. Puck popped out in front of Strinkert, and as he stood up, it just dribbled in underneath him.
Oh, that's too bad. That was an unfortunate goal.
Felt like Everett was just starting to get their wheels back under them.
Yep.
All right, it is now 4-3 in favor of Vancouver. 13:55 remaining in the game. Man, I gotta tell you, I am so tired of this song.
No, I can't even hear it.
It's that Take Me to Church song. It gets played about every 3 seconds. McCutchen lost the puck there, and Vancouver able to take advantage. Incidental trip from Meineker. Vancouver's pulling the puck up around at the point.
Comes right back behind the Everett net, collected by Walton.
I keep confusing Walton and Meineker today, and I don't know why that is.
Walton on the sideboards completely
boarding call.
Completely gets pasted there. That's a
Head contact. It's a big hit.
I think the guy's elbows were a little high. So this will give Everett a chance at a power play. In the, well, that's a bad focus job right there.
Well, that was,
looks like a shot from the blue line from Poland gets gloved up or saved by the Vancouver goalie. Yeah, you know, whenever you're recording outside one of these rinks that has the mesh, it wreaks a little bit of havoc when you try to zoom in. The camera was doing a pretty good job here before, but comes right out front for Lombard. Lombard can't quite connect to it, and it comes back for Gaumont.
Yeah, we've got a nice vantage point here today.
Yeah, this is a
plus. It's
nice.
Warm, so that's a plus up here in the restaurant.
Lombard takes a shot, goes wide, collected by Althoff. Althoff looking for Poland. Poland slides it right out front. Sounded like it hit the post. Comes back to the blue line. Gaumont takes a shot. It gets blocked. Gets tipped by the goalie. Lombard with it on the left-hand side boards. Goes back to Poland back to Lombard. Lombard can't hang on to it and gets grabbed up by Vancouver. Vancouver slides it out to center ice, and they end up dumping it out of play.
That was between the blue lines. I was going to ask in the NHL if that's a delay of game. I think when you're between the blue lines, it's not.
Yeah, it's not. Now, like this, you know, like this rink that has the low glass here in the corner, I'm sure that that'd be classified as a delay of game. Comes back to the blue for McCutchen. McCutchen shuffles it up to Mietsma. Mietsma can't hold on to it. Disrupted by Walton. Walton streams over the blue line, takes a shot, gets blocked by the Vancouver goalie. It's for Herman. Herman slides it back for Walton. Again, Walton playing way high and forcing Herman to go low. Nice pickoff by McCutchen.
Yeah, it was a nice bit of footwork. 18 seconds left in the penalty kill.
Walton up to Herman. Herman up to Meineker. Doesn't quite connect. Back to Walton. Walton again streaming over the zone. Taking a shot. Gets blocked. Oh, Walton's like everywhere.
Yeah, he's having himself a nice game. I said penalty kill earlier when I meant power play, by the way.
Yeah.
Oh. Off to the races.
Yep. Comes for Vancouver. Vancouver picks
great
it off.
Great save. Great
nice.
Save.
That was a great save by Strandkirk.
Puck got behind Strandkirk, and as he fell back, he got his glove on it and pushed it forward. Beautiful save.
I don't even know if he actually saw that or if he was just falling back and put his gloves, you know, put his gloves down on that play. Was there a penalty on that?
May have been.
Oh, there's a penalty shot.
That stick.
There's going to be a penalty shot.
Oh, my goodness. I haven't seen a penalty shot in probably 3 years.
No. It's a little unheard of.
Number 10. Number 10's tall.
Yeah, he's a pretty big boy. Well, let's see what number 10 does here.
All right, Craig, stand tall. Beautiful.
Yeah, Strandkirk doing a great job there, pinching that off and keeping Everett in the game here. That was
the Iceman.
That was a good job here by Strandkirk. Again, Strandkirk having a pretty strong game here.
Yeah, he's made some good saves, but none bigger than that one.
No, that was really needed.
Oh,
no way.
And that, on the other hand.
So there's a shot from the top of the circles there that just gets tipped by Everett and goes through the five hole of Strandkirk.
Yeah, he was just slow getting down. Yeah, didn't get into his butterfly quickly, and it just went right through.
That was a tough goal here for Everett. Score is now 5-3 with just under 11 minutes left in the game. We've got Wyrick over to Corson. Corson can't keep control of it. Corson grabs it, takes a shot right into the... There's that focus again. That was right... It was right into the chest of the goalie there when you had Meineker right on the side looking for the rebound. You should have shot it low for that rebound. So we'll go ahead and have a face-off here in the Everett zone.
You know, Corson showed up to the holiday party with a half gallon of chocolate milk and chugged the whole thing.
No kidding.
Yeah.
Comes up to the sideboards. Vancouver behind their own nets, chased down by Meineker. Comes out of the blue line for Gaumont. Gaumont takes a shot. It gets blocked, picked up by Meineker. Meineker shuffles it out front. Vancouver disrupts it and puts it on the sideboard. Vancouver dumps it into the Everett zone and chases after it. Gaumont trying to disrupt it behind the Everett net. Slid up by Wyrick.
It's good physical play by Gaumont, just never letting that Vancouver player establish himself with the puck.
Over to Meineker. Not sure what happened there.
I think Flo lost track of it.
Yeah, I think it got caught up in his pants or something like that. Comes up for the blue line for Vancouver. Vancouver gets pinched by two Everett players, and Walton picks it up behind the Everett net. Walton off the sideboards to nobody, and it comes right back. Everett's got to do a better job at actually connecting to players that are on that sideboard. They're just making that blank pass. Lombard tries to shuffle it out front. Can't quite connect to it. And it comes all the way back again. Another one-on-one for Vancouver. Mm. You know, I really think that this game is where it's at because of our offensively minded defense leaving that hole on that blue line.
Yeah, no disagreement from me. There've been
numerous two-on-ones, one-on-ones. Yep. I'm all for offensive, defensemen, but if you're going to come over the blue line and you're going to cause a turnover and then you're not able to get back into your position, you have no business doing that in the first place.
Yeah, I agree. Got to be a defensive defenseman first.
Yep.
And when that is rock solid, then you can play up.
Yep. Herman with the face-off. Good pinch here collected by Vancouver.
Tripod move. I believe he learned that from you.
Yes, there you go.
Well done.
Well done. He actually listened to me. At least I have one 15-year-old that listens to me. Picked up by Herman. Herman streaming into the zone. Takes a flop shot, gets gloved up here by the Vancouver goalie.
Yeah, I think he was hoping Meineker was going to be able to get in, and when it didn't look like he was going to quite make it, Herman went ahead and took that shot.
Yep.
A pretty low percentage shot, but we'll get a face-off in that end.
It's a shot nonetheless.
Hey, so we're perpetually, not so much we as you, are perpetually stymied by Anderson and Poland, numbers 10 and 11. I just thought this would amuse you. I learned that that the two of them are taking driver's ed together.
Oh, no way.
Yeah.
The Planderson.
It'll be the Planderson student driver mobile.
Oh, my goodness. That just makes me laugh inside. Herman collects it on the sideboard, tried to push it up for Mietzma. Doesn't quite connect to it. Back for Gaumont. Vancouver puts it right out front, wheels and deals, and puts it right into Stringkirk's chest. Awesome. Which is a great thing.
Sorry about that.
It's all right.
Get my timing right.
It's all right.
We're a little rusty too after a month off. So number 15, Vancouver, there had some really great footwork to get that puck into position on his stick and pass it in to set up that play. It was a really nice play.
Yep. You know, the new system. Since we are left and right, we can talk at the same time.
Oh, that's true.
That's right.
That's true, but I still feel like it's rude to interrupt you. My mom told me not to talk with my mouth full and never to interrupt Mike Mietzma.
It's like quit talking already. Coursing up to Weirich.
So I'm just going to interrupt you now, just because I can.
Yeah, sure. No, it's not like the mic just cuts me off.
No, not at all.
Just go ahead.
I got nothing to say. I just wanted to interrupt.
Oh, okay, good. Do it anytime. Horson slides it over to the blue line. And Vancouver will pop it all the way back into the Everett zone for the icing. Now you may say something.
Oh, thanks. 7:32 left in the third period. 5-3 Vancouver. Everett's got to turn it up a little bit here. I felt like this game was theirs for the taking after a strong showing in the first period.
Yep.
I feel like the teams are well matched.
Yep.
But Everett's squandered a couple of, well, not so much squandered opportunities. I think it's just let some things get away from them.
Defense. I agree. Comes back behind the Everett net. They come up on the sideboards. Comes up disrupted by Weirich. Weirich streams into the zone, looking for a shot. Tried to slide it through the five hole of the goalie and was unsuccessful.
Yeah, Weirich can't get no satisfaction.
No.
But he tries. And he tries. And he tries. And he can't get no
satisfaction.
Weirich
on the face-off here. It comes back to the blue line for Walton. Walton takes his shot, goes wide. It's picked up by Weirich.
You know, we pick on Weirich, but Evan Corson's another famous equipment forgetter, most specifically his jerseys. And I understand that the captains texted him about 30 times today.
About 30 times.
Make sure
times,
that he remembered his jerseys.
Yesterday and today.
Weirich's mom lighting it up down to my left.
Lighting what up?
Her son.
Oh, she's lighting her son up.
Yeah, I heard a very solid, come on.
Come on.
What are you doing?
That'd be a stern talking to after the after the game, I suppose.
She's like 20 yards to my left.
And still maybe too close when the arm starts swinging. There, Corson.
Nice pass.
Corson over to Anderson.
Wow, great save there.
Oh, man, I didn't actually get that, but that was Corson to Anderson to Altoff, and all of them were trying to slide that past the Vancouver goalie with not that much success.
No, great initial save by the Vancouver goalie, and then the puck was laying all alone to his left.
Yeah.
And an easy, easy opportunity, but he was able to get over and get a piece of it. Great save by Vancouver.
Comes up, or comes all the way out to the Everett goal line for the icing, and we'll have a face-off all the way over in the Vancouver zone again.
So I neglected to mention at the beginning of the game that Nate Altoff is now assistant captain as well. So
yes.
So we've got Meineker, Mietzma, and Altoff as the assistant captains on the team now.
Comes back to the right-hand side for Vancouver. Vancouver streams over the Everett blue line, wheels and deals, gets pinched by Gaumont, picked up by Poland. Poland slides it up for Altoff. Altoff can't hang on to it, gets grabbed up by Vancouver. Vancouver on the left-hand side boards, pops it behind the net for another Vancouver player, which pops it up to the side boards. They do a great job cycling that puck on the side boards. Goes up for Lombard. Lombard one-on-one, tries to do a wheel and deal there, but gets picked off. Grabbed up by Altoff. Altoff at the blue line just pops it into the Vancouver corner. Vancouver picks it up or collects it behind their net and shuffles it towards the blue line. Big shot by Walton to the opposite corner. Nobody there to chase it down. Looks like Van... not sure what that whistle was for. But I will take a break here to have some water while they're trying to figure that out.
Well, I was watching Walton behind the play. It looked like a slashing penalty here has been called. I was watching Walton behind the play. He was slow hustling back around.
So is he in the box?
No. It looks like it's a Vancouver player.
Oh,
so it was unrelated. I was just watching him come across with his looking tired.
I see. Okay.
Scoreboard's all messed up here. I don't think they have the penalty, right?
No.
Looked to me like they got 20 seconds rather than 2 minutes entered on the scoreboard.
Nice pass from Herman to Mietzma. Mietzma drops it back to Herman. Herman gets disrupted, and it comes out of the zone for Walton. Walton cross ice for Herman. Herman slides it into the zone, doesn't quite get it all the way there, and Vancouver plops it all the way up. Poland back with it, makes a stop behind the Everett net, looking for that breakout.
Vancouver creating a lot of traffic here.
Yep.
Ah.
Yeah,
just pushed it out to nowhere there.
You can't do that. Comes on the side boards for Meineker. Meineker just throws
hooking
it up.
Penalty's been
hooking.
Called.
So that was a whistle.
So the scoreboard operator missed a zero when entering the two-minute penalty earlier.
Oh, yeah.
That we hit was it only went up for 20 seconds. So I don't know quite how much is left. I'd guess about a minute 10 of that original penalty. Hooking penalty.
4 minutes left in this game. Score is 5-3.
Well, you know, it's actually 4 minutes and 11 seconds, and in 11 seconds we'll be kicking off the Canadian four, the 4 minutes of all Canadian all the time.
I can't do that today.
Oh, come on now.
I can't do that today. Vancouver, Poland streams up the ice there. I'm in Canada. You know, I was actually talking to my wife and saying that it was pretty pathetic that I can't speak Canadian on cue.
Big scrum in front of the net there, eh?
Yeah, it was a great, great scrum in front of the net.
Boys are wrestling around a bit. Minute 34 left in the penalty, the hooking penalty.
Hooking
penalty on the Everett Silvertips,
where he went around and a boot his way to hook him. Herman with a good face off there on the side board comes around for Vancouver. Vancouver lost sight of the puck here, or I lost sight of the puck. Vancouver comes over the blue line. It's popped out by McCutcheon. Wonder if McCutcheon's name in Canadian is McCutcheon.
McCutcheon? Boys from North Van are swirling around. Quick shot.
Swirling around. Swirling around. You do a much better job at that than I do.
You just haven't had a nip yet today.
No, I haven't had a nip today to get my lips ready. You failed me. And I came all the way up here. I got over the border and went, dang, I forgot my my go juice. Anderson streaming through the zone, gets pinched by two Vancouver players, and it comes right back out. Everett just not doing a good job, you know, collecting and keeping that puck. Looks like everybody grew. Comes right over into the slot, comes down for Vancouver. Vancouver waiting, being very patient, putting it right out front. Vancouver rifles the shot, goes wide, wide open, over the net. See, I should have had my nip today.
Yeah, you got to pour back a Mickey before the game.
That's right.
Get yourself in rear form.
That's right. Good disruption by Poland, picked up by Wyrick. Wyrick slides it into the Vancouver zone. And Vancouver comes up very quickly with it. Gets disrupted by Poland. Comes back for Stringkirk, and Stringkirk will cover it up, and there will be a whistle on the play.
Oh, he never really got his glove on the puck there.
No, he really didn't.
Out the side. The official was early on the whistle. Kind of a bonehead whistle, eh?
Totally bonehead whistle.
North Van had a good opportunity there, and the official hosed him.
Hosed him. So we've got Rohde taking the face off with Meineker. Comes up, Vancouver has it behind the Everett net, streaming back to the blue line. Vancouver being very, very patient. It's incredible that Vancouver is in the box and they're playing us like we have a penalty.
It's all even strength now, eh?
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
Okay.
A little bit ago.
Vancouver doing a great job here, just manhandling Everett. Walton behind the goal. Grabbed by McCutcheon.
I heard a whistle there.
Yeah, it's a little bit deceptive. I think maybe that was on the other rink.
Oh, that could be. Oh, big
comes
hit
up
there.
For Lombard. Lombard rifles it into the other zone for an icing.
Got a penalty called on that.
Ooh, for what?
I'm going to guess it's interference.
That'd be Vancouver going to the box.
Yeah, the boys from North Van blew up number 14 there on the boards.
Yeah, blew him up.
Just on a minute to go.
Maybe we need to go out for a rip.
We most definitely need to go out for a rip after the game.
That's what I'm thinking. We need we need to find a place that applies a little bit of sustenance to the players, and have a rip.
Yeah, boys will be gut foundered after a game like this. We'll get them out and get them a bite.
Wow, that's a great word. Looks like these lines are all sorts of messed up. We've got Rhodey playing center.
Well, we pulled a goalie here. Stranker's on the bench. We've got six.
There we go. Might as well see if we can't get something happening here.
So that may not have been a penalty at all. They may have just been calling Stranker off.
Yeah, maybe.
Six attackers.
Comes out Vancouver. Vancouver with the puck. They slide it out to the blue line. This does not look good. Offside on Vancouver. There's a half of Everett's team is out here on the ice today for the last 49 seconds of the game. So we've got Meineker, Mietzma, Herman, Rhodey, Lombard, and Meineker and Walton.
Oh, my goodness. They're like bumblebees.
Yeah. Comes out for Rhodey. Rhodey on the right-hand side. He turns and he just passes away the right-hand side over to Meineker. Meineker on the side boards. Goes down to Mietzma. Mietzma up to Meineker. Meineker can't connect to it. And so was a little bit of a slap in the face there, eh?
Yeah, but he made sure he didn't miss.
Yeah, he made sure he didn't miss.
There's nothing worse than missing on a shot like that, so.
Yep.
Took his time, got it right.
Well, it's a great job here for Vancouver. And I'm not sure if I was Mietzma, if I would have passed it back to the blue line in that particular situation, but.
You actually are Mietzma.
Oh, yeah, Mietzma. Then I wouldn't have passed
wouldn't
it
have
back to
that.
The blue line, not necessarily because Meineker was there, but there was a guy behind the net that should have been there.
Well, that's going to do it for this game.
That is going to do it right up.
6-3 in favor of North Van.
Comes right out front. Poland slides it out of the zone. And that's it for this game.
So a decent matchup, I think, for the Everett Silvertips.
Yep.
The score didn't reflect it, but I think this is a good team for us to be playing.
Yep. So we'll play them again tomorrow. Again, Everett with their modus operandi, I guess. This is kind of what we do. We come out hard in the first, slack off kind of in the second, and let them collect some points. And then have a little bit of a week of start of the third period, and then seem to come out relatively strong in the end of the game.
Yeah, I agree. It seems to be modus operandi is a good word for it. A little bit of our Achilles heel here is I don't know whether our boys get a little tired at the end or whether they're just not maintaining drive throughout the whole game. Not staying hungry. Stranger's coming off the ice looking pretty unhappy. I think he played a decent game.
I think so too, yep.
He gave up maybe one or two soft ones, but he made some tough saves.
Yep.
And
no, I agree. So that'll about do us for the voice of the Junior Silvertips, Mike Mietzma.
Brian Herman will be back tomorrow morning, 8:30, I believe.
Yeah, 8:30. Have a good one.